Could we have Vicki Bryant come up and Martha May Martin? I think most of us know both of these ladies. I've got a little bit I want to share about my friend Martha Martin. Martha has deep roots in the city of Arlington and a great passion for history, genealogy, and historic preservation. She knows her history, especially Arlington history. Martha is a fifth-generation descendant of the pioneer Gibbons family and was raised hearing stories of the challenges faced by the early Gibbons settlers in 1860. And the contributions that her ancestors from the Gibbons, Rose, and Denham families made to the community and in the development of the city of Arlington. She is proud of her rich heritage and has rallied around the cause for saving many significant historic structures in Arlington, with some successes and many disappointments. Martha has one foot anchored in the past, but is always looking forward towards the future. She believes that historic and environmental preservation should be top priorities in her greatest legacy. And in 1982, Martha completed her first narrative for the Texas Historical Marker at her Gibbons Family Cemetery on Davis Drive. Subsequently, she assisted with the THC markers for the City of Arlington and Top Hill Terrace, for which I'm thankful. At the request of the City of Arlington Parks and Recreation Department, she wrote the family history for a marker recognizing the 200-acre land donation made by her aunt and Uncle Joe and Berta Rose Brown and her mother, Margaret Leslie Rose May, for the Rose Brown May Park, now River Legacy Parks. A major project for Martha, supported by Landmark Commission, was the writing of the tour of the Arlington brochure that guides citizens through the Pioneer Trail with historical narrative about local structures. And in 2007, she helped to update the Arlington Historic Resources Survey. Martha was delighted that the Rose family was chosen along with five other families to be honored in the Founders Plaza. While serving on the City of Arlington Landmark Commission, she assisted with the research for the designation of the second historic district in Arlington, the South Center Historic District, located in the Mayor William Rose Addition, which resulted in the district being placed on the National Register of Historic Places. And in May 2015, Martha was honored to present the district's history during a City of Arlington marker dedication. She has also contributed information for the acquisition of the city markers for the city, for the Arlington Post Office, which is now Worthington National Bank, the Fannish Vandegrift Building, and the Arlington Theater. And in 2013, the Arlington Historical Society recognized the 150th year of the Gibbons family settlement in Tarrant County. Most recently, Martha submitted the nomination for a marker to commemorate Arlington Downs, and is looking forward to the dedication next spring. She has her eye on honoring many other historic sites in our city that are worthy of recognition. Martha is married to Ronnie Martin, a retired mechanical engineer, and they have one grown daughter, Melissa Rose Martin, which they're both here today. Martha spends much of her retirement with family on what remains of the original 1,329-acre Gibbons homestead in North Arlington, and enjoys expanding her knowledge of local and state and national history. Martha attends First Methodist Church, where her grandparents Delia Ditto Rose and James Preston Rose were charter members. In 2014, First Methodist Church honored her family as being founding members. In the past, Martha has been recognized by the following organizations for her fundraising efforts on their behalf: Arlington Historical Society, Cancer Research Foundation of North Texas, Arlington Animal Services, Assistant Dogs of Texas, and Levitt Pavilion. Organizations she's been involved in: Arlington Historical Society, City of Arlington Landmark Commission, the Markers Committee, Arlington Preservation Foundation, Arlington Garden Club, Arlington Conservation Council, Arlington Women's Club, Encore, Alpha, Delta, Kappa, Neighborhood Associations, and the First Methodist Church Historical Committee, and Adult Bible Class. You think she deserves a support? To be able to present her with this award, because she's been a big blessing in my efforts with Top Hill.
And so fitting that it is the Tom Vandergriff Award.
True.
Comments. I am just honored by this award. This is a truly a lifetime honor for me that I never thought would happen, especially with the association of Tom Vandergriff. It isn't about me, it's about my family. And it's about, I wouldn't be here if it weren't for my Pioneer family, and if it weren't for Tom Vandergriff, who this award is named after. So I would like to, if we have time, to make a few comments about my family that settled in North Tarrant County in Arlington by the Trinity River. If we have time, do we, Joe?
Just a tad.
Well, I have the reputation for going on and on, so I will start by saying that in 1856, I think that Tarrant County was having an issue with Birdville as far as the county seat. Am I correct?
Hello.
I mean, it was a major issue.
Yeah.
Which 3 years, there were votes for the county seat. The final vote was 1860, which awarded the county seat to Tarrant County, of course. But that 1856 date was very significant, not only because of the shootings and because of the liquor that was sold for votes, correct?
It wasn't sold, it was given.
Oh, it was given.
And my great-great-grandfather was a gentleman who organized siphoning it off in Birdville and bringing it to Fort Worth so my great-great-great-grandfather could have it there in his store.
Is that art back there? That's art, okay. I should have checked with you before I told that story.
They taught Lyndon Johnson everything he did.
Well, now I can believe that. But the reason that that year was significant, 1856, is because Governor Peace gave a patent letter deed to a Ruth Brown, no relation to my family. And then Ruth Brown sold, it was 640 acres, sold that property to Middleton Tate Johnson. And then Middleton Tate Johnson sold it to a Mr. Randall, no relation to Randall Mill. Then finally was my great-grandfather's turn to buy the property, of which he migrated from Tennessee in 1860 to Young County. The census records show that he was a merchant. In Young County. There were many deprivations there at that time, if you remember. In 1860, and settled by the Trinity River in what is now North Arlington, where River Legacy Parks is. That was the 640 acres that he purchased. It was a challenge for him. That property has been passed down for many generations. My daughter, Melissa, let me introduce her, Melissa, is sixth generation, and my husband, we couldn't have kept the property without them really taking a part in the preservation of it. There were many challenges. James Gibbons and his son Thomas Gibbons were the pioneers of the property. Thomas Gibbons married a Martha Gibbons, my namesake. And at that time, there were no schools over in the area for Martha's daughter, Ollie, or Martha to go to where she could go to school. So he donated 1 acre for, it was school district 49 in Tarrant County. So she could ride her pony across the pasture and go to school. And I'm sure that there were just a few other children that went to that school also. Ollie, Martha's daughter, married William Rose, who was an early mayor of Arlington. And he developed a block in downtown Arlington, one of the first, right across from UTA. As a matter of fact, I'm getting off of the subject, but I had a call from John Hall at UTA. That block is on the National Register, and he said, we would be interested in buying those homes, you know, as they become available. I said, oh no, I said, that's on the National Register. We only have two historic blocks and our designations in Arlington. And I told him over and over again that my grandfather developed that area because it was close to the inner urban. You remember the inner urban? It was close to downtown Arlington. It was only two blocks from Abram Street, two or three blocks from Abram Street. And I said one of the main reasons that he built that he started that development there was because of Grubbs Vocational College. I said, do you remember what Grubbs Vocational College was? And he said, oh yes. So anyway, with Diane Patrick's help, we saved our block for the time being. So this property, the Olin Gibbons, that was a brother to Ollie Gibbons, was a county commissioner, a Tarrant County commissioner. And as I said, it's gone from generation to generation. We've done the best in keeping it. We've had so many offers, you know, to sell, with the last one being a Fortune 500 company. Of which we thought about, and we refused on that one. It is so important, as you said, to keep the records. My daughter and husband can tell you that they cannot walk through the house without stumbling over either a box of papers or some type of historical records that I have kept. I still have the newspapers. I have not let go of those newspapers. I have the abstracts from 1856 for the property of which, when Governor Peace awarded or deeded that property to Ruth Brown. The deeds, the abstracts are like this. And they stopped when my grandmother started selling the property back in the 70s. As I said, we have a little left. I have a Texas historical marker on the Gibbons Cemetery. Hopefully, we will be getting a City of Arlington marker at that one, too. As Martha Gibbons said, my namesake, she said, there's something here for every generation. There's something here for every generation of our family, and there's something here for every generation of the families in Arlington. And I can see that that was a truth. She had the foresight of when her husband passed away, of keeping the 1,300-acre farm, which had sharecroppers, 11 sharecroppers' homes. It was planted in orchards. Cattle were there. It was a self-sustaining. So she had the opportunity of selling that, walking away from it, or keeping it. She had the fortitude to keep it. And now we're trying to keep the little bit that we have left, which is when people come on the property, they say, where did this come from? Because we're kind of a wilderness, and we have Cooper and Green Oaks. We're right at the corner of Green Oaks in North Arlington. Cooper was Gibbons Drive, and the City of Arlington changed that to Cooper because they wanted it to go from south to north. So that was changed. And my family has always thought a lot about history. And so my aunt saved the sign and put it up on the corner right there at the entrance to the property, and the city made her take it down because people were getting lost. So I have story after story, you know, to tell about that. Gibbons Road, that was Cooper, was put in by prisoners, Tarrant County prisoners, the road was. Gravel Road, and there's just a lot of history. We are in an area that is literally the cradle of civilization, because Bird's Fort is not far from us. Middleton Tate Johnson, of course, started his plantation over in South Arlington in 1848. We have history all around us. Unfortunately, we did lose our downtown. We have tried to keep as many historic buildings as possible. It broke our hearts to lose the Eastern Star Home, of which there was only one in the state of Texas. We do have the Masonic Home. That was built in 1911. Eastern Star was 23 in 1923. We would have loved to have kept that building. We worked very diligently to do so, and all the other buildings that we have lost, even our downtown. As far as the angel that's available, I hope that you don't keep that angel as long as we did Kayla Moore. Remember, it was like, you know what Caleb Moore is? And that was locked up in a warehouse for years and years and years, and now it's down in Richard Green. Yes, Art?
I was going to say, anybody who's seen Indiana Jones knows all about Tarrant County warehouses, and because of state law, they have to keep an unbelievable amount of stuff. And one angel more or less is no big deal.
Well, just one thing. As I said, I wouldn't be receiving this award if it hadn't have been for my family and the effort that they put forth to keep the property. Also, another person, Ms. Tom Vandergriff. And I have just one thing. I feel like people. I know, just one thing. I feel like people will appreciate this. Tom Vandergriff, our mayor, from 1951 for 26 years. My family, when they gave the 200 acres for River Legacy Park, wanted to do that while Tom was in office. And so it was given in 76, and he retired December 77. He was a person that everything was we, not I. He did what he could for the city. Our city was located in an area where we were going to have growth no matter what. But of course, many things happened with General Motors, with Great Southwest, with Six Flags Over Texas. Arlington has grown from when he became mayor, it was 8,000. Now we have like 360,000 or so. We had a fundraiser, Arlington Historical Society. We honored all the mayors of Arlington. We've lost many since then. This was a time back, a few years back, and we asked for a bio. And a funny thing about your life, and I was chair of the fundraiser at that time, and when Tom passed away, I saw Richard Green and told him that I had that bio, and Richard said, "Oh, could I have it for, because I am giving a presentation at the memorial service." And so I would like to read part of that, because this is Tom Vandergrift all over. May I do that? Are you applauding me to leave? or to read it?
No.
You will find enclosed the biography and the photograph previously.